My presence here, everyone, is being the committee chairman on the Committee on City Government, Personal Government, and Civil Service Committee of the 17th Council. I'm not giving you the sports message because it would be Councilor Uy who would be giving this for the culmination activity for the Miss Week celebration. Again, my respect to our acting City Mayor, Gemar Veracruz, and also our acting City Vice Mayor, Councilor Ryan Ong, the members of the 17th Council in attendance, the City Government Department heads in attendance, our guests and visitors from AFP, from MNLF, and also to MILF, the presence also of Ma'am Beth Buna of representing the DILG, and also Director Aluna. From time to time, gapanawag ko kang Director Aluna, especially on the Committee on Civil Service. Thank you so much. In one, isa ka po, tawag eh. Sa akong mga kauban sa buhat sa City Government of Iligan, kaninyong tanan, maayong puntag o advance Merry Christmas kaninyong tanan.
Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas! First and foremost, this is my first time to be here, of course, in the Office of the Human Resource Management. For the incoming next month or year, the Committee on City Government Personnel would be called the Committee on Human Resource Management and Civil Service. No, because we already have an amendments the previous session. Being the committee chair on the personal government management and civil service, naghantay nakita na angay buhaton gayon sa maong komitiba. In fact, when the vice mayor developing and crafting the internal rules and procedures, this is for information of everybody, this is the first time in the history of the Sangguniang Panglungsod na naay committee nga mututok gayud sa human resource management and civil service. Ato po siya palapatan kabahin ni Ana Butanga. For one and only reason, because the observation is kinahanglan yun matutokan because angay tanawon, especially on the Human Resource Department. There were a lot of concerns na maabot usab sa mga respective na mga buhatan na before, this is under the Committee on Labor and Employment, which is brought kaayo sa natanan, focus on the external affairs of the City of Iligan, which is wala yun nakatutok sa City Government. And we challenged the Office of the Human Resource Management to look into on the succession plan, knowing the fact this is one of the big problem. Because 2 years from now, when I check all the structures in each department, mura po collapse ang City Government. And because that there is an alarming problem, this is, we cannot deny that, the Committee on City Government Personnel Management and Civil Service submitted to the 17th Council the proposed ordinance for the fixing the hiring rate of contract of service and increase the wage of the job order employee and casual employees. And for what reason? 2 years na nakabinbin more ang 365. In fact, the tripartite labor will increase at probably by next year by 20 pesos increase per day with COLA. So, kung hindi pa mag-increase ang City Government, most likely, we will be delayed on amount of 40 pesos per day per employee. So, naku kay siya backlog. And we incorporated this for the fixing hiring rate of contract of service because we observed that from time to time, how the City Government will treat on the professional license in terms of hiring. We believe that there are professional licensed engineer hired by the City Water Works, and also of some professionals wherein ang ilahang hiring rate is dili kayo matawag na competitive. Of dalit kay kabihaan. And in order for us to hire to be competitive, our proposal is that this will be observed in the salary grade 11 of third tranche. So hopefully if the council, through the help of the council and the support, our hiring rate for the professional license will be at the range of 20,000 entry rate level. Of all licenses like engineers, CPA, radiologist, medtech, matawag na to, social work, licensed social work. And we also have a specialized rate intended for the hazardous work. When Councilor Bartilio asked if you come up a study in your community, how we are going to come up in our garbage collector, especially PSD, because that is under of his committee. And I also look into consideration of that particular and very important the workers sa city government. And for that, naakay, we propose for incorporated of that particular ordinance to have a minimum, to have an entry rate level of the garbage collector, traffic enforcer at the same time sa ato ang mga hazardous work. So it is the job now of the department heads to submit and identify the hazardous work in your respective department in order this will be incorporated. Otherwise, kung hire mo o empleyado, man kamo mo determine mga hazardous, then the ordinance will not meet being a definition of the hazardous. So, dili siya mahatagan because dili siya ma-level sa entry rate na 365. We propose on the administrative fee, which is 403 per day. If the ordinance will pass, ang atong garbage collector, dili na mag 365 or sa karon 338, they will be receiving a 403 per day as well as the traffic enforcer. Ato pong mga chlorine hunter, atong naa sa City Hospital, na very hazardous kayo, there will be also an entry rate level of 403 and an increase of 5 pesos per year within 3 years. Kasi it will depend on the local chief executive and also sa city veterinarian fund, no? Kaya nangangistipulate po yun na, and oh no, we'll just pray at ato mga department heads, maglabutang pangulitao sa ato ang mga city councilors that this will be approved because this is for the welfare of our people. The purpose of which is to stabilize while the CHRMO and the mayor and the vice mayor is on the process of filling up in the appointment of the vacant positions in the plantilla. Kapalumi na ang City Hospital, daghan kayo ang concern. So, the propose all professional license such as nurse, engineer, medtech, radiologist, social work, veterinarian, agriculturist will have an entry rate level of salary grade 11 of third tranche, which is 20,179 per month in a contract of service. Tama ng civil service din eh. At ang mga director is just to aron matuko siya because we have a labor problem. But I know that the civil service ruling, kabalo na mo ana the functions of a regular employee. Nakastipulate niya upon all the provisions of the civil service, we also incorporated on that ordinance. And also, the committee also already approved the ordinance of institutionalizing of payroll system of the non-regular employee. So pasabot, tanang mga job order, hopefully by next month, ako nag-set up ang system. It would be a computerized system na sa itong payroll system. There will be a cut-off period sa tanan na itong mga panwilduhan. Aron mahimong untok, aron mahimong regular panwilduhan. For example, if your job order is 3 months, you will be receiving 15 days your sweldo and 30th day. Makakuha mo sa inyong sweldo on time. No, on time sa itong mga job order employees. Katong mga nagpaabot sa ako ang opisina na naay mga deduction, it also less than job order na naka, this is for public information and grabis opportunity, katong less than 3 months ang job order, hindi na mo pwede madidakan sa ubang mga deductions karon. Because as provided to the civil service, that is optional. Na i-job order na 1 month, 1.5 month, 2 months, 2.5 months, din na mo deductionan of withholding, pag-ibig, SSS, because that is, job order is a no employee-employee relationship. So katong more than 3 months, na may 5.5, no, naman na, pero 1 year, pero katong every 15 days, so you will be deducted as consignment, i-deduct ka ron sa job order. So, katong mga last na 3 months, hindi na magka-problema. Again, if you will receive your, for example, January 15, ang imong cut-off sa imong payroll is December 26 to January 10, munay sweldo nimo sa January 15. However, if you will receive January 30 of your sweldo, January 11 to January 25 ay yung cut-off period sa imong computation sa inyong sweldo. So, mga sweldo din mo, pizza 15 o pizza 30, dili na pumutong tulong kabulan. Tungod kay nana mo yung approved job order. For as long as it is approved job order, dili deployment. Wala, we cut off also the deployment. All preparations of the job order is directly job order na po months. Based on the approved ordinance. So, it already signed with the mayor last November, so it will be implemented. So, amo na lang ipaabot. Again, I hope it is already included also in the citizen charter. Kaya, ingon siya, this will be in, ingon siya, na dapat ako ning isulod sa citizen charter. I hope na appeal to asa to si Glenn. Na-appeal. The last, na-appeal ba to? Napasa? I hope na maapas ba? Kanara may bronze na ito pa, no? Nako kayo mga opportunity. So, kana lang and the rest of the proposed ordinance will be tackled on the first regular session on January, which is the amendment of the burial assistance and the hospitalization assistance of all regular employees. Kasi wala kabalo ang mga regular employees, there is already a existing ordinance for that, so we have to amend because that was already 2003 ordinance intended for the regular employee. Again, daghan kayong salamat. We will be witnessing the sports activity, the basketball friendship game in the combination program of the Peace Week. And kami niyong tanan, daghang salamat ug maayong buntag.